Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Sonikku Hīrōzu. Last time we finished up Team Dark's story by doing Egg Fleet, Final Fortress, and of course the Egg Emperor, and this time we will be doing Team Rose. Oh boy, let's go.
We're up! You can count on me!
Okay, here we go!
Hey, you guys! Cheer up! You know we'll find them! No time to waste just standing here! Come on, let's get going!
Okay.
Alright, Team Rose! And we actually have an extra stage with Team Rose, being Stage 0, Seagate. Practice team action. Now, I am just gonna be going ahead and skipping through all of this because it's basically just a really long, really drawn out tutorial where Omo Chao teaches you basic team action that I've taught you all already, and he has a lot of dialogue, so you can probably hear me spamming the A button just to continually... Whoa, he didn't actually do it there. Just to continually skip all of his text and all of his dialogue and just not have to listen to this crap. Alright, he's gonna talk again? Yep. He's gonna tell us about the homing attack. And Amy failed, but Cream and Big didn't. Also, this is Amy. I'm playing as Amy right now. She's a tiny bit different to the other team speed characters. We also have Cream and Cheese. Cheese is the chow, by the way. Cheese, really, Cheese is actually... oh god, he wants to tell us about the frigging thunder shoot, and I'm already doing it. Cheese is actually Cream's solo attack, like... Tails and Rouge had the dummy ring bombs. When you play as Cream and she's by herself, she shoots cheese at people. The chow, not actual cheese. Also, press and... Oh, wait, hold on. There we go. You jump, but while... Just hold A instead of just, like, tapping it. And you do the little, hammer spin thingy, which is basically, just another way for Amy to, like, jump, I guess. Because, I mean, she has the homing attack. All the speed characters have the homing attack. But for some reason, they give her an extra one. So we have to rocket a cell here, and it didn't want to work. Stop it. Go. She's doing a really awkward hammer attack as well. Alright, power cores. Actually, I didn't know that was their official name. Also, if you jump and press B, that is her tornado attack. It actually goes out in front of her, as opposed to the other ones, which just kind of happen where you are. Big also, as you'll see here, when in the air and you press B, he doesn't do fire dunk, he doesn't do fire launcher, he does a body slam. He basically just body slams enemies beneath him. Also, you can press B to put Amy and Cream on his shoulders, and then you fire them off like this, and the third attack, he spins around his fishing rod, and of course, the higher leveled you are, the more damage that will do. Their team blast, actually, I think it actually will tell us the name of it here. I think it's actually called Flower Festival or something like that. It is the most broken team blast in the whole game. Oh. Oh, that was a little awkward. Okay, that's two episodes in a row when we've had a weird flight animation glitch like that. Alright, Thunder Shoot. We kind of know already how to do that. Let's go. And it's going to want us to Thunder Shoot these as well. Friggin' shut up, Omo Chao. I know what I'm doing. I don't quite understand why they put the tutorial in Team Rose's story, because no one's gonna know that Team Rose is easy mode, because it's the third team. Everyone's gonna use Team Sonic, so why not put the tutorial in Team Sonic's story? That's something I never quite understood. Also, you may notice this. This is Big's equivalent of the triangle dive. He just pulls out his umbrella, and the characters will grab hold of him while he flies into the sky like that. So, yeah. You're a quick learner. Let's destroy all those enemies. What? Okay. I think it's going to tell us about the team blast. Is it going to do it here? You may have already noticed pressing B power formation. No. Let's just... Also, it says if you press the B button at the right time while in power formation, it's literally just a case of just spam the B button and you'll do the combo. So, yeah. I'm surprised it actually hasn't told us about Triple Springs. I mean, maybe it has and I haven't been listening. Now for the special attack, Team Blast. When the thing, you can do the thing, ultimate attack, let's give it a try. Okay, so it's not actually going to tell us the name, but let's go ahead and use it. It's a friggin' ridiculous attack. Not only does it get everyone one level up, it gives us a shield, invincibility, and that's about it. But yeah, it's ridiculous. Anyway, that's the end of Seagate. It's a friggin' ridiculous level, but... Well, it's not ridiculous, but when you've already played through two stories, you don't need it. I don't quite understand why they put it there. But they do. Like, put it... You should have it in every story, and you should have the option to quit it. Yep. Also, yes, the Team Blast is called Flower Festival. Anyway, Stage 1, Seaside Hill, get to the other side of the sea. Okay, no intro dialogue. I thought there would be. So, the one thing you'll notice about Team Rose is there is going to be a lot... Also, holy cow, really? There's going to be a lot of formation signs. There's going to also be a lot of formation change gates. They really kind of baby you in Team Rose's story. Which is fine, because, I mean, it's supposed to be... Oh, thank you, Cream. It's supposed to be easy mode. And, I mean, it is easy mode. It's not just supposed to be. But the, it's just, it's weird, because it's the third team. You would think that they would have, maybe they do have somewhere in the game a thing that says that they are easy mode. But that's also the reason why a lot of people will recommend, if you want to get all of the Chaos Emeralds, would recommend getting all of them in Team Rose's story. Because if you fail the special stage, it doesn't take anywhere near as much time to get back through and do it again. What?
Here we go. Here we go.
What? Okay. All right then. Hoo hee indeed. That we've had so many glitches so far. Okay. Right. So the main thing you'll notice about Team Rose's story is the stages are pretty much identical to like Team Sonic's and stuff like that, but made considerably easier. Like a whole lot easier. And did we? Oh, I thought that we had the glitch again. That would have been really awkward. I don't even know how that glitch happened, but okay. But yeah, the stages are very similar, but made incredibly easy. So, that's gonna be the main thing that you notice about Team Rose. Also, one little thing, if you do the ground pound and then immediately switch to Amy, you'll be going really frigging fast when you switch to her. I'm not sure why that is, it's some kind of momentum glitch, but you wanna go fast, and if you've stopped, and you wanna go fast, do that. Alright, can we make- okay, that did actually save us right there, that's fine. I want, you know, I'm gonna use the, wait, is this gonna tell us about the A thing? Yes, it is. Let's press and hold A. Whee. I've never really found a use for this, especially when you can just play as, Cream, but I guess if you want to do that, you can do that. Also, the one thing about Big when he goes through those things with them on his shoulders, they don't spin around, so he's just kind of left there with them in an awkward sitting pose, so. No, I don't want to be Big, I want to be a different character, because I don't want to be Flight going in here. Also, one other thing you'll notice is Cheese gets left behind quite a lot, but he always somehow manages to catch up, so good on you, Cheese. Also, I think Big was already level 3. They probably didn't need to do that. Everyone gonna go through? Yeah! So we are still getting all of the points for that, just because they're not, because their animation isn't playing, it just kind of makes it seem like maybe we're not getting all the points, but we definitely are. Level up! Okay, Amy is still not level 3. I kind of figured it's Team Rose. Everyone's probably gonna get leveled up really quick, but I guess not. Alright, let's go. The thing... something about the tornado attack that Amy has. Also, we got Speed Shoes. Oh, I think that's another thing that the Team Blast gives us. Speed Shoes. Look at all the babying they're doing right now. Formation change gates that we that we don't need. But yeah, also, this is the end of the level, by the way. The one thing that I can say about this move is it makes flipping over enemies a lot easier because you don't have to be right on top of them. But that's kind of the only thing that's really different about it. I don't find much other use for it, I guess. Also, although actually no, I tell a lie. It can be used in like Frog Forest to make the flowers come up and then you can grab it with someone else if you want, but whatever. There, we did it. And their ending pose is pretty adorable, I must admit. I think Cream is probably my favorite. Also, geez, Amy. Okay. Oh, that's gotta be an A rank. Yeah.
Super duper happy.
All right, Big. Yeah, I was going to say, that's got to be an A rank, because we got, like, 50,000, and it's Team Rose! Kind of a big deal. Team Rose gets really easy A ranks. Okay, Stage 2, Ocean Palace. Find the ruins floating on the sea.
Wow! What a beautiful white palace! Amy, we're not here to sightsee!
Froggy!
So the main thing about Team Rose's story, actual story, not gameplay or anything like that, is they're trying to find Froggy. Yes, Big lost the freaking frog again after Sonic Adventure. Because he just, that's just what he does. Okay, no, Big, that's what I wanted you to do. Why is it making a switch to fly? I don't want to be babied. I want to be able to switch when I want to switch. Just give me the formation change, or the formation sign, and let me decide if I want to change, okay? Thank you, game. That's how this is supposed to work. Oh, I can't complain. I mean, this is easy mode. Also, look. Whoa! That's... I actually really like how they changed up the triangle dive for this team, and the Team Chaotix triangle dive is actually different as well. I guess it's not technically called the triangle dive, but I kind of like how they changed it to make the team a little more unique, because Team Rose is very much just, easy! I can't explain it other than it's easy. Also, whoa, okay, no, I want to get the, whatever that was. 5 rings, definitely needed that. Okay, Amy, stop it. I don't like using the rocket cell with Team Rose because Amy will decide she just wants to do that weird attack. I'm not even sure how you pull that attack off, but she likes to do that. Also, one thing that Amy cannot do is the, triangle jump. She can't jump off of walls, which is a little bit annoying, but it's not really needed. Like, there's nowhere in these levels where she needs to do the triangle jump. Hello, cheese. So, yeah. It's just not needed, basically. Anything over here? Enemus! Enemus! Get wrecked, scrubs. And that one didn't even wake up for his death. Well, I guess he did right at the end there, but still. So, I'm kinda hoping that we can go through all of Team Rose's story and not have to use a continue. Not a continue. Jeez, this isn't all-star mode. And not have to, what am I trying to say? And not have to come back through a level. I'm saying, oh my god, hold on, let me think. I hope we can get through Team Rose's story and get A ranks first try every time. That's what I was trying to say. My words would not come out. Alright, this one guy right there, okay. Let's do the thing! Go! Did we get the other one as well? Oh, I wouldn't know, actually, because there was no power-ups. Oh my god, it took him forever to get over to me right then. Oh, okay, let's go speed, I guess, because I was already speed. Froggy! I want to find Froggy! Yes, Big, honey, we know that you want to find Froggy. But that's the one thing about Big, he does not shut up about Froggy in this. At least, like, Cream is not always talking about Chocolate and how they're trying to find Chocolate. I didn't actually mention that. They lost friggin' Chocolate as well. I think this is actually the first game Chocolate was introduced in. I think it's just another Chow who is somehow related to Cheese, maybe. But they lost them both. And they think, because of one apparent news article that they got, they think that Sonic did it. But as we probably all know, there's been a little something showing up in certain cutscenes who looks an awful lot like Sonic, so who thinks it's actually Sonic? You know, oh, bye then. Fine. I'll admit, I know a lot of people hate Big. I can see why a lot of people hate Big. I actually really like him. He's one of my favorite Sonic characters. Also, look, 4 minutes, and we're at the goal ring. How short do these levels need to be? Okay. Well, like, 15 minutes into this episode, we probably would have just finished a level in Team Dark Story. And, oh. We got, like, no level-ups. But we had a lot of time bonus, so with any luck, A rank, oh yeah. Super happy. Also, when I was saying I hope we can get A ranks on everything first try, I'm not including boss and team fights, because I was actually playing through on another file, just because I wanted to, I guess. I just wanted to play the game. And I was fighting Team Rose with Team Sonic, and it took me forever.
So you're the ones who are playing games with my army.
Dr. Eggman!
You little crap, I'll show you a thing or two.
Eggman, are you up to no good again?
How adorable is Big? Yeah, it took me forever to beat them because for some reason it just wasn't working. Also, I find probably the best way. Actually, no, that's probably not the best way to take these out. I always thought that taking out the Egghawk with just a body slam was a good idea. I guess it is. Okay. It kind of looked like it wasn't doing as much damage as it should be, but there you go. Just body slam the Egghawk a few times. And it's done. I guess they probably made it have less HP or take more damage with Team Rose. So, yeah.
That was a huge birdie.
Big, you lovable thing, you. Anyway, that is going to do it for this episode of Sonikku Hīrōzu. So, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Make sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed, and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, where we will be doing Grand Metropolis and Power Plant with Team Rose, and I'll see you guys then.